rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi alladhi yujibuni hina unadih wa yasturu alayya kulla awratin wa ana a'sih wa yu'azzimu an-ni'mata alayya fala ujazih nahmaduhu wa nusabbihuhu wa nuqaddisuhu ala ala'ihi wa na'ama'ih wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah ilahan wahidan ahadan fardan samadan qayyuma نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وعترة نبيك الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه الميامين ومن تبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قال ربك للملائكة إني خالق بشرا من طين فإذا سويته ونفخت فيه من روحي فقعوا له ساجدين صدق الله العلي العظيم The creation of man is made of a commixture of two things. One is material and the second is immaterial. The material is a handful of dirt. إِنِّي خَالِقٌ بَشَرًا مِنْ طِينٍ From clay. Handful of dirt. فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ Once I mold him and shape him. وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِ The second part is a breath of spirit. وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ And this intermingling between the dirt and a spirit that has a divine trace in it. وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي It is necessary for this journey in this life, for our journey. It is necessary to create this internal struggle inside us. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ This life is about bala. It is about test. No one is going to pass this life without experiencing this test. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا We created you to put you into test. And then through this test, the result of this test that lasts for many decades, 70 years, 80 years, 90 years, then either we deserve going to paradise or we don't deserve it. We deserve something else, the result of this test and this life. This blend and this mixture and this infusion between an earthly part, which is the dirt, al-tin, and a heavenly part, which is the divine spirit, وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. This is the reason for the struggle that we experience. The internal struggle that we experience day in and day out, in every life, in our life. Because these are two powers that are trying to polarize us into two different directions. The teen, the element of material and dirt in us, the earthly element inside us, always tries to pull us down to the earth and to the products of this earth. It tells us that you have to eat, and once you eat, make sure that you are full, full. One, I have a friend who's overweight, and the doctor keeps telling him that you have to take care of your health. So he asked the doctor, what shall I do? The doctor said to him, don't eat the last three bites. So this friend was telling me, he says to me, I don't know where are those three last bites. This is the problem. Because he keeps eating and there is still room, mashallah. So he does not know where to stop and say, okay, these three, I will skip them. So this earthly element says eat, drink, enjoy, relationship, unrestricted relationship with the opposite gender, opposite sex. Seek this, seek that, acquire this, dominate here. This is the earthly element. But then we have the spiritual element. وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. That always tries to lift us up, to elevate us to levels of sublimity, levels of highness, spiritual highness, moral dignity. And this struggle is continuous. The struggle does not end. Don't think that the struggle ends when we pass the teen years, when we become 20 years old or 30 years old, or some people think at 40 years old this struggle would... No, the struggle is continuous. Until the last day of this life, these two powers are fighting with each other. It's inside us. The teen, the dirt says, you have to be attached to this earth, to this life, to this dunya. While the spiritual element says, you have mabadi, you have principles, you have values. And this struggle showcases itself in three main areas in our life. We can see them. Visible in three main areas. One of them is between selfishness and selflessness. Selfishness and, on the other hand, selflessness. This element shows itself. This struggle, it is visible in this area. Some people, they live for the sake of themselves only themselves. The only important thing in this dunya, in this universe, is them and no one else. And others, they live not for themselves. They live for others. You can see the difference. The other area where we see this struggle is very visible between the earthly element, the teen, the clay, the dirt, and the heavenly element, the spirit, the ruh, is what philosophers say, al-mahdudiyya, on the one hand, the narrowness, exclusivity and narrowness of the person, the confinement, when he confines himself or herself within certain narrow boundaries. When it comes to his race, he confines himself only within his race, only within his culture, only within his religion, only within his neighborhood, his country, his community, versus someone who is universal. someone who knows that he's a member of a greater society called Earth, the people of Earth, not the people of Iraq or Afghanistan or Iran. I'm a member, I'm a citizen of this Earth. Maybe my government gives me a piece of paper, says this is your citizenship, document, passport. It has no value. I'm a member of this universe. Universal view, not regional. Not regional view. The day the Muslims are going to be successful and productive, when they reach out to others, they don't keep Islam for them as a private commodity only. They enjoy it. They don't allow others to enjoy it. When you open up to others. So narrowness in perspective, in life, in approach, versus openness and open-mindedness. You have a free spirit. You can transcend these artificial boundaries that we created for ourselves. Just a few days ago, two people came to the office. They love each other. They are young. They want to get married. But their parents are against them because someone from this nationality and the other is from another nationality. And both parents of both those guys, the parents of the man and the woman, they oppose. They say you have to marry from within your own culture, your own culture. You can't. Where is it in the Quran Allah says marry from your own culture? Where is it in the hadith of the Prophet? The Prophet married almost 13 wives, each one from different culture and different religion too, and different color too. Where is it? This is narrowness. This is when a person confines himself, imprisons himself within artificial boundaries, man-made boundaries, versus someone who is universal, who is a global in his thinking. He has a free spirit. And the third area where we see this conflict, very visible, profound and visible, between the earthly component of us and the heavenly component, is the struggle between aql, reason, and desire, and shahwa. And we have this struggle on daily basis. On daily basis, hourly basis. There is a fierce fighting, fierce clash between aql, reason, on the one hand, and passion and desire on the other hand. Plato says that man is composed of three powers. One is reason, second is spirit, and third is desire or passion. He says whenever we allow desire to overcome reason, aql, then we find unhappiness. We're going to find confusion. Do you see some people who tell you, I'm confused? I don't know what to do. I need help. I'm confused. I'm lost. Why he's lost? God wanted him to be lost. God created us. So we are lost and we are confused. He does that deliberately to hurt us. God does not want you to be lost. He wants you to. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ. We created vision. External, internal, inner vision for you to find your way. To chart your way. I don't want you to be lost or confused. It is you who choose being lost in this life. When we allow desire to knock down the reason, then he becomes lost and confused. And he becomes unhappy in his life. The results are not good results. Gharaiz and desires always are demanding, ever demanding, pressing us. Go after this, go after that, go after this goal, go after that material goal. And this would not end. These demands would never stop. Would never stop. And desires tell us that go and don't ask why or how. If you are hungry, eat. Don't ask about the source of the food. Whether this food is lawful or unlawful, it belongs to me or it does not belong to me. Don't ask about this money. You need money, get it from wherever you can. whatever means, drugs, alcohol, theft, robbery, stealing, fraud, get it. You need this money. These are the desires. The aql says no. Aql says you have been guided by, you have something called in this life, principles and values, qiyam, principles. You have to go by the book with these principles. Allah says you are hungry, yes, you need food. فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ. Look at that food, examine it before you eat it. You need money, yes, definitely you need money to survive. Look at the source of income. Don't go after the unlawful source. Don't make your life miserable and the life of those who live with you miserable just because you need money. Because sometimes that money is going to destroy you because it came from a lawful source. And we need you to build yourself, yourself with your wealth, with your money. When we follow desires, we reduce ourselves to the level of animals. Sometimes Quran says in Surah Al-An'am, even lower than animals. Lower than animals. Because animals, when they eat, they are hungry, they eat. When they are full, they don't go after the food anymore. They leave it for others. Some people, they are hungry, they eat, they are full, but still they fight and they don't allow others to eat the food. Inhum kal-an'ami balhum adhal. Animals do not have reason. They don't have aql, we have reason. This is the difference. This is the difference. Allah says you want to get married, fulfill your desire. There is a lawful way for it. You need to get money, there is a lawful way for it. You need to eat, to have food and a drink, there is a halal way for it. Don't go through these. Don't go after these through the unlawful means. Therefore, the aql, أول ما خلق الله سبحانه وتعالى العقل. There is no blessing that God has given man better than عقل and reason. The hadith says, لا دين لمن لا عقل له. No faith for someone who has no عقل, no reason. He would not have faith. ولا مصيبة كعدم العقل. No tragedy, no loss bigger than losing one's mind and one's reason. وَمَا قَسَّمَ اللَّهُ بَيْنَ الْعِبَادِ مَا قَسَّمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى بَيْنَ الْعِبَادِ أَفْضَلَ مِن نِعْمَةِ الْعَقْلِ. Allah gives many bounties and gifts. To someone He gives children. To someone He gives money. To someone He gives power. To someone He gives beauty. But then the best gift of Allah that He distributes among His servants is aql, reason. It reminds me of a story of Harun, the Abbasite Caliph Harun. He had an advisor who kept asking him every evening to drink, to share the drink, alcohol with him, wine. And this advisor kept refusing. He says, لا يا أمير المؤمنين, I'm not for it, I'm not for it. One night, Harun said, tonight you must drink. You have no choice. You must drink. I'm your leader. I'm Amir al-Mu'mineen is asking you to drink alcohol. So he said to him, but before you force me, let me ask you a question. Answer my question. He said to him, why did you choose me to be your senior advisor? Is it because of my family, my lineage? He said, no. I don't even know your father or your family. He said, is it because of my wealth? I'm a successful businessman. He said, no, you are broke. You are penniless. He said, is it because of my physical attraction? He said, no, definitely not for that reason. He said, then why you chose me to be your senior advisor, Mustashar? He said, because of your brain. He said, then if this is the case, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, don't force me to do something where I lose my brain, and if I lose my brain, I lose my position with you. I lose my job. You want me for my brain, and if I drink alcohol, I'm going to lose my brain, and if I lose my brain, then I have nothing left. The only thing I have, the only asset I have is my brain. Do you want me to lose it? Someone was telling me the other day that, do you know why divorce in America is on the rise, higher than other countries? Compared to Europe, rate of divorce in America is higher. And Europe, compared to the Middle East, is much higher. He said, because most of these decisions for marriage are made in cabarets and nightclubs when they are drinking under the influence. They meet each other under the influence. Both of them are drinking, heavily drinking. Then they fall in love and they then decide to get married. And in Arabic, we say what the wind brings, the wind also takes away. Something that comes under the influence is going to go away also under the influence. This is why they don't make a rational decision. They don't make rational decision. This is why Islam says stay away from wine, alcohol. Stay away from that. You are not going to see pleasing results in your life when you drink and when you allow your family to drink. This is not good for you. Stay away from it. Use your brain. When you make a decision, use your pure brain. Do not contaminate this brain. This is a God-given gift. Keep it strong. Keep it healthy. Keep it away from these intoxicants. When Adam was created, first thing Jibreel came to him, he said, Allah says you have three choices. If you take one, the other two are going to leave you. Allah says, either مُخَيِّرُكَ, giving the choice between عقل, we give you reason, or we give you حياء, shyness, or we give you deen, faith, religion. So which one are you going to choose? But remember, if you choose one, the others are going to leave you and go. He thought for a second, he raises his head and he says, I choose aql. I choose the reason. So Jibreel turned to shyness, haya, and deen, and he said to them, leave him. Leave him and go. They said, no, we are not going to leave him. لقد أمرنا الله سبحانه وتعالى أن نتبع العقل حيث سار. Because Allah asked us that wherever this aql reason goes, you go after him. Don't be separated from it. When you have aql, you have everything in this life. And when someone does not have aql, doesn't have aql, what beautiful the Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, نوم العاقل نوم العاقل أفضل من سهر الجاهل. Someone who has reason and aql, even when he sleeps, he's more productive than someone who does not have reason. He's ignorant and he's awake. The productivity of someone who has sanity and reason, even when he sleeps, is more than the productivity of someone who's insane but he's awake. نوم العاقل أفضل من سهر الجاهل. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي ابن موسى ومحمد ابن علي وعلي ابن محمد والحسن ابن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي المقصرة المذنبة بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره روي عن سيدنا ومولانا الإمام أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام أنه قال الدنيا كلها جهل إلا مواضع العلم والعلم كله جهل إلا ما عمل به والعمل كله رياء إلا ما كان مخلصا والإخلاص على خطر حتى ينظر العبد بما ختم له صدق أمير المؤمنين عليه الصلاة والسلام. One of the most brilliant analysis of this life. Is it provided by someone who was not attached to this life? He lived in this life, but he was not attached to it. If we become attached to it, we can't analyze it. We can't even see it. We will be drowned and submerged in it. But someone who kept a distance between him and the attachment and the fascination in this life, he was fascinated in the Akhir. Our imams, they lived for the Akhirah. They lived in this life, but not for this life. They passed through it. Their ultimate goal and destination was the Akhirah. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةَ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. If we seek that final destination, then you're going to be successful. فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. We're going to be grateful to them. We're going to observe what they do. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, "الدُّنْيَا كُلُّهَا جَهْل" is full of ignorance. إِلَّا مَوَاضِعُ الْعِلْمِ. Whenever there is a piece of science, a piece of knowledge, ilm. Also, ilm وَالْعِلْمُ كُلُّهُ جَهْل. Ilm is going to be darkness. Except the part that you practice, you put into practice. Otherwise, ilm, you store it in your brain and you don't practice it. What's the benefit? What's the benefit? The hadith of the Prophet ﷺ says, when sometimes some of the scholars are cast down in Jahannam, in hellfire, scholars, ulama, يَتَأَذَّى أَهْلُ النَّارِ لِرِيحِهِمْ. Even the people of the hellfire are going to suffer from their odor and their stink and their smell because they know that a scholar has been cast into the fire. The Prophet says those scholars are the one who preach but they don't practice. They know they have ilm but they don't put it into practice. It's like a doctor who cures the whole community but himself, whenever you see him, he's sick. He cannot take care of himself. What do you say about him? He tries to heal others while himself is sick. Al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wa salam says, إِنَّ الْعَالِمَ إِذَا لَمْ يَعْمَلْ بِعِلْمِهِ زَالَتْ مَوْعِظَتُهُ مِنَ الْقُلُوبِ. The alim, the scholar, if he does not practice his knowledge, he does not put it, his maw'idah, his admonishment to the community is worthless. Worthless. Does not even go into their hearts. They don't listen to him. He cannot change because he himself has a problem with that. من تعلم العلم ولم يعمل به. هذا حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. من تعلم العلم ولم يعمل به. He's learning, but he does not practice. حشره الله يوم القيامة أعمى. He's going to be gathered on the day of judgment blind. So Imam Ali says, والعلم كله جهل إلا ما عمل به. Even ilm is going to be darkness except the part that you practice. You put it into practice. وَالْعَمَلُ كُلُّهُ رِيَا. The amal that we do is not dedicated, is not sincere. إِلَّا مَا كَانَ مُخْلِصًا. Accept what you really seek, only God for it, not people. You care less about people and what they say about you. You only care about Allah. إِلَّا مَا كَانَ مُخْلِصًا. وَالْإِيْفِنْ إِخْلَاصُ عَلَى خَطَرٍ. Your sincerity, your dedication, your earnestness also in pearls and danger. إِلَّا accept the end of your journey. If the last few days, last few weeks, months, years of your journey is safe, then the entire journey is safe. حَتَّى يَنْظُرَ الْعَبْدُ بِمَا يُخْتَمُ بِهِ. Wait until see what is the result of your last part of your journey. Sometimes you begin strong and healthy in the wrong direction. Halfway through, you make a U-turn. Don't you see some people? They started with good faith, pure faith, but then dunya changed them. They married the wrong person. Sometimes his wife was good, but the son, the daughter, they corrupted them. Sometimes a partner from outside, a neighbor, a co-worker, a friend in his family, a family member, a relative, they divert them. حَتَّى يَنْظُرَ الْعَبْدِ بِمَا يُخْتَمُ بِهِ. The important thing is حُسْنُ الْعَاقِبَةِ. How are we going to die? That's very important. What is the last chapter of your life? When you leave your life, how is it? Are you still strong in your faith? Or you say, I was 30 years ago, alhamdulillah, 40 years ago, I was good Muslim, now I am not a good Muslim. That does not count. حَتَّى يَنْظُرَ الْعَبْدِ بما يختم به. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات. اللهم اجعل عواقب أمورنا خيرا. اللهم لا تخرجنا من الدنيا حتى ترضى عنا. اللهم من على مرضانا بالشفاء والعافية. اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين على الخير والبر والصلاح والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين. وعجل في فرج سيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. صدق الله العلي العظيم، وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين.